Hey everyone, Luke here with another episode of Wednesdays with Wimber, and on this video, I want to talk about something that I found people really love about John Wimber and the legacy he left behind. Some people obviously are not huge fans of this, but it's maybe because they weren't expecting it or they had other reasons, but what I'm talking about today is John Wimber's way of dialing down the atmosphere during what he called ministry time. So let's get to it. You know, there are a lot of stories floating around the internet and around certain circles about things that John Wimber taught or what he thought or what he believed. And I found that if you really want to know what Wimber actually thought or taught, you actually have to look at when Wimber said those things, because Wimber, like most of us, actually changed his mind on things over the course of his life. It's actually one of the reasons why I like John Wimber so much. He was developing and learning and growing, and his experience helped shape whether he thought certain things that he said or certain practices were still helpful. And he was obviously constantly studying the Bible and engaging some of the best scholarship available to him. But one thing that I have heard over and over again from many of the people that spent time with John Wimber is that he would oftentimes lead what he called ministry time, and in the middle of ministry time, when people were able to receive prayer or could share prophetic words or people could pray for healing or deliverance, one thing that you hear a lot about was that John Wimber would regularly dial down the atmosphere. In fact, sometimes right at the height of the prayer, right when it was getting really good and everyone in the room was ready to get super spiritual, John would call for a chip break and he'd go get a bag of potato chips, or he'd get a Coke, or, you know, sometimes I know in the middle of ministry time, he would actually have the dim lights go brighter so that everyone could see what was going on. John didn't want people to miss out on learning how to do kingdom ministry. He worked hard at equipping women and men to do the stuff, and he would do whatever it took to get people to have the presence of mind to observe what God was doing, even to the point of killing the vibe during a ministry time clinic session where people were doing the stuff. Dialing down the atmosphere is, I think, a vineyard value that works in most contexts. Though our commitment to exegete culture and to stay relevant to the world around us is obviously going to cause us to consider what that might look like in the context we're in. And I guess that's part of why Wimber's way of dialing things down was so attractive to people. At the time, people were used to either really formal church gatherings or really hyped up services, and so people often felt like they couldn't really be themselves. So Wimber's encouragement to being authentic definitely connected with a lot of people. I think this is one of the reasons why Wimber was so winsome to so many people. People loved that he did not take himself way too seriously. I mean, who shows up to a church gathering with some of the best worship leaders around and tells everyone that they're just a fat man trying to get to heaven? Obviously, John was much more than just a fat guy trying to get to heaven. But his ability to joke around and his self-depreciating style definitely connected with boomers and lots of Gen X people. But here's the thing. After pastoring in several vineyard churches and being around a lot of vineyard pastors and leaders, I think it's safe to say that this laid-back atmosphere of dialing things down is not for everyone. Some people really like the hyped-up culture, and they really expect the church leaders to have it all together and to be stodgy and serious reverends. So it's just how they are wired and what they expect in their church culture. They can't help it. In fact, I think the whole chill and relaxed environment that oftentimes is found in vineyard churches actually gives them anxiety. And while I would want to point out the messy nature of the kingdom of God and how following Jesus and walking in the Spirit means that sometimes things don't go the way we expect, and that Wimber's purpose of dialing things down was often for the sole purpose of equipping people and training them to know what was going on so they could be more effective at doing the stuff in their own context, I just know that it's not for everyone. But that being said, I find this dialed down approach still very helpful in today's culture. I mean, people are still very skeptical and even have a negative assumption about what Christians are going to do or think or say or what's going to happen in church because of the assumptions they have about church gatherings. So people tell me all the time in what they love most about the church that we are a part of is they love the culture of being more laid back and how there's no pressure for people to act a certain way in order to fit in or to be spiritual. What do you think? How would you explain Wimber's idea of dialing it down? Would you connect it to the idea of being authentic and being culturally relevant? And do you think it still matters today? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. My name is Luke Garrity, and I'm a pastor theologian in Northern California, and I want to thank you for watching this video. I'd love to encourage you to like my Facebook page. You can follow me on Instagram and Twitter, and definitely subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks a lot for watching.